radar is found in 2 Chronicles, the 7th chapter, verse number 14. And it simply says,
yes, sir.
If my people were to call by my name,
yes, sir. Yes,
sir. To humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sins and will heal their land. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of God. And just for a little while, I want to talk about the remedy for making a great nation. In the 7th chapter of 2 Chronicles, we find here where a building of a temple has been erected under the reign of Solomon, the son of David. Now, King David had passed the scepter to his son Solomon, and the people rejoiced at God's goodness. Now, God chose to magnify Solomon because Solomon magnified the Lord. David died, but the throne of Israel continued. Although God marries his workmen sometimes, he still continues his work. Even though David had his struggles, when he passed the scepter to his son Solomon, it was a great nation at the time. And we find in 2 Chronicles that Solomon began his reign in fellowship with the Lord. But gradually, his heart turned away. And he began to worship the gods with a small g of his many foreign wives. So if you read the book of Deuteronomy around the 17th chapter, 14 through the 20 verses, it warns the Hebrew kings not to multiply horses and chariots, wives, or gold. But Solomon did all three of these things. You know, that is how it is in our lives today. It is when we begin to do things that the Word of God tells us not to do. It is then when we begin to have a spiritual decline. We see in the biblical history that during the years of Solomon's reign, undoubtedly were some of the greatest times in terms of wealth, fame, and political power. But they were also the worst times in terms of spiritual devotion to the Lord. Amen. It was because of these things that the great nation of Israel had lost its spiritual status as well as its greatness in the eyes of God. Now we need to understand that it doesn't matter how much we are allowed to accomplish by well positions and material status in our life. If we don't have Jesus as the head of the life, if you haven't been born again, you still doesn't have anything. We have a president-elect that has been appointed by the people. And because of the election, a lot of folks seem to be worried about the future of our country because of the direction that Trump said he's going to lead some of his people to. But he never said anything about God. And I've even heard some folks saying that in Trump we trust. But as children of God, in God, we trust. I don't know about anyone else, but I feel like Joshua. And Joshua said, as for me and my house, yeah, I'm going to serve the Lord. And I stand and let it go on record that in God, I trust. And in God is whom I pray. And just like Joshua said, choose ye this day whom you will serve. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. As I first stated, the reason for our nation of Israel's decline from the greatness that they once knew was because of their disobedience and their negligence to the command of God. And I just want to say that disobedience and negligence to the Word of God are two of the driving forces and factors that in the lives of so many people that has caused some folks to be in the worst positions in their life that they ever been.
Yeah.
These two things determine the outcome of how our physical lives in so many ways are destined. We can start out doing great in whatever it is that we're doing. We can be enjoying and experiencing the greatest times in our lives. But all of a sudden, things can turn around for the worse. All because we were disobedient and we did not listen to the command of the word of God. When the Lord has blessed us, if we're not careful, Satan will make it appear that it's all about us. Look at what I have. Look at what I've done. And all of that, we don't have a desire to seek God for the thing that he allowed us to achieve. We become disobedient because we're not seeking God. And if you're not seeking God, we're most likely neglecting the reading of God's word. It's impossible to obey the rules if you haven't read the rules, to know what is expected according to the rules. This is why so many are lonely people who seem to be doing fine in the eyes of folk. But when they get back to their homes and their houses, they're so all alone. Even some that are in marriages and relationships, when you think how a relationship should be, they think they got it together. But they don't know how to have a relationship because they don't have one with the Lord. In order to have a relationship, first you must have one with God. And if you want to know where to find the instructions, where they're written on relationships, it's found in the Word of God. And God will inform you what to do to have a true relationship. Now, what I'm saying is that you must have a relationship with God first. And then, in His time, if you follow the rules, you will have a true relationship that only God can give. Solomon began his reign at the altar, sacrificing to the Lord and asking God for wisdom. But after being blessed of the Lord, he didn't continue in that way. Instead, he furthered his luxurious living by collecting food and taxes from the people. And due to this, the people became burdened by the yoke that Solomon had put upon them. It was so Solomon, he even reorganized the 12 tribes into 12 tax districts. And with each district responsible to provide his food one time a month. And these things caused a great decline in the greatness of the people of Israel. The city that once was known for its greatness had been led astray because of disobedience and negligence. But what I love about the God that we serve is that God loves us. He's willing to make good on his promises. This mic is raining. Now, at the time in the 7th chapter of 2 Chronicles, the people had given all they had to build God a house. Now, not like today when we talk about building God a house. Many people just have reservations. But in order to receive the blessings of God, one must make sacrifices in order for God to get his glory. For whenever God gets his glory, he always reciprocates. He gives back to us more than we could ever give back to him. But in order for him to do this, we must do some things. We must humble ourselves under his hands. We must pray for the removal of the judgment for the sins that we've committed. We must also seek the face and favor of God. Now yet, with all of this, it's still not enough. Except we turn from our wicked ways and turn to God. God will not bless our efforts. At the time of our text, the sacrifice was now in order because the temple had now been erected. Solomon prayed in the prior verse, chapter 6, prior chapter, and he laid out the You know, there's something about the presence of God. You can go to church sometimes, not feeling your best. But when the presence of God begins to move, you find yourself saying, glory. Thank you, Jesus. And you know why? It's all because God is in the room. I said that to say this. If you want something to be great again, you must get into the presence of God. If the marriage or relationship that you once had isn't great anymore, the job you have isn't great like it once was, the relationship with your so-called friends and family is not great like it once was. I heard somebody say our country is not great like it once was. But Trump is not the one to make it great again. I stopped by to change it. I got a remedy. Give my God to make the things great again. It's not found in the president. It's not found in Congress or in other political arena. You'll find it here in 2 Chronicles 7:14. If my people, what you call my name, shall humble themselves and pray, seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from them and will forgive their sin and I heal their land. It's not about us. Doesn't matter who's in the White House. It doesn't matter who's in authority. But God is still in charge. It's all about giving God the glory. In spite of who gets the credit, God will get the glory. This is why when you come to church sometimes, Satan sits beside you and try to scatter your mind. Keep you from focus. Sits beside somebody who wants to talk. Make you sleepy. Sit by somebody who's negative. And before you know it, the service is over with. And you ain't got nothing. It's because Satan intended you to come to church. But he didn't want you to get that. Sometimes, maybe go and do some stuff for you. Even me. Get in trouble all day long. And never think he got you. That's good news this morning. He messed up. Made one of the biggest mistakes he made in his life. He let you come to church this morning. Now stop by to tell you that the glory of the Lord. Tell somebody glory. 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 Lord, send the glory.
Myself.
my covenant people. And because your hands is covered with blood, I can't let you build it for you. But the Lord gave me the permission to store everything that will go into the house of God. God gave his son Solomon the privilege to build God a house. And it was a privilege because God's glory will fill the house. The house of God was built to bring a covenant relationship between God and the people that he made. Man had become alienated from God, except the high priest would go in and make an atonement for our sin. Even when Solomon built the temple, the glory of God filled the house. But every year, the high priest had to make a sacrifice. And then go behind the holiest of holies. For the priest had to remove the veil. In order for one priest to go into it and make an atonement for our sins. But if the priest was not right, and the atonement was not accepted, then you have to go another year without the favor of God. But I'm so glad that God said enough is enough. I hear the Bible speaking to me according to Hebrews 4:15, where it says we have not a high priest which cannot be touched with the feelings of our infirmities, but was at all tempted like as we were, yet without sin. In order for us to get a final atonement, some blood had to be shed. In order for us to bathe in the glory of God on a continual basis, some blood had to be shed. I just don't understand why some folk get quiet when they start talking about blood. And sprinkle it on the altar. He will heal man. You'll hear from God. Those are the church.